Hello and welcome to the AFMC Student Portal video. In today's tutorial, we are going to show how to submit an application through the Student Portal to a Canadian university. Now, do bear in mind that this is our testing system. Not all the information you're going to see will be relevant, but all these screens have the same function, so it will look sensibly the same. Now, when you first log into the Student Portal, this is what you're going to see. This is the student dashboard, so it shows you what action is required, unread emails and things on your to-do list. You'll see in-process applications. You'll see that I've got a few here because I've done this video before. And most importantly, you see this big blue button on the right. It says start a new application. Now, a lot of students will click on this button and they'll end up in this list and there's nothing in the list and they get stumped. They can't go any farther. Now, there are some steps that need to be followed before we can submit an application, so we're going to go through those. Now, when you first register for the portal, the first step that you want to do is to complete the My Profile section. Now, this has all your relevant information about you. So there are four tabs here. The first is the personal tab. So you have your salutation, your name, date of birth, your language, and citizenship and country of birth. The contact tab will have all your contact information, which includes your emergency contact and your permanent, current, and mailing address, which you can duplicate if need be. Notice that when you do change the information, you can click the update button at the bottom here. The homeschool tab will have all the information about which school you are coming from. Now you'll notice that when you pick your homeschool, it'll automatically populate with the address. You'll have to put in your student number and information details on your program and graduation. The homeschool official will populate automatically if you are choosing a Canadian university. If you're choosing an international university, you'll have to fill this in on your own. Be very careful when you fill this in. You want to make sure this is very accurate. If this information is not accurate, then this can cause some problems down the line. And finally is the academic tab, and this is what I like to call the student resume. Essentially, this has information on the core rotations and clinical electives that you have done already. Now, normally you would have more than these. I've just got three here as a sample. And you'll notice that there are different statuses. So we look at two that were done in the past. For example, today is May 7th. So if we look at rotations that were done in the past, you'll see that they're complete. And we have one set in the future that says that it's not started. Let me just show you what it would look like if we were in the middle of it. So let's just change this one to 6 weeks. You'll notice that it changes to in progress. That means the portal knows if I'm in the process of doing it, if I've completed it, or if it hasn't been started yet. And this can be important to coordinators receiving your application. If there's anything missing here, if you haven't done this yet, you can click on the Add New button, and you'll have the same interface. That's my profile section. So we now have all our information input into the portal. Now next up is to look for what electives we want to apply for. And we do that through the Visiting Electives Guide. Now in the Visiting Electives Guide, we have a search box here where we can look for specific opportunities in Canada. We can just click on the magnifying glass to have everything show up from the guide. See here that all the different schools are there. Or you can filter it by host institution, by medical specialty, or by language in which the elective is offered. Now, we're applying to the fictional Sandbox University, which is our test system, so I'm just going to show how the filter would work. There we go. And you can see here that Sandbox offers two different electives. Now, there's this cardiology one and the internal medicine one. Now, we already have a lot of information here. We can see the specialty and the subspecialty. If there was a specific location or year offered, we would see those here. We can see that the language in this case is English, as opposed to our internal medicine one, which has both English and French. Now, if I want to find out more about these electives, I can click on either the title or on the magnifying glass on the right. And here I have some various information, such as the description and the year offered and the length of the opportunity and so on and so forth. We have information on the fees here at the bottom. And on the right, we can see who's eligible, locations, if any, as well as placement contacts, if any, have been determined. Now, I look at this elective opportunity and I decide that I want to apply for it. So what do? I click Add to Wishlist here at the top right. You'll notice that there's a confirmation message that pops up. And the star that was gray is now gone amber, which shows that it's in my wish list. If I mouse over that, it'll ask me if I can remove it. So basically, this is like a shopping cart. I've put this elective aside to apply for it later. Now I can go back to the list, and I can look at another elective, for example, the internal medicine one. And I look at all of this. I've got more information this time. Everything looks good again. Fees and all that, and I go, yep, I want to apply for this one too. So I'm going to add that one to my wish list. So at this point, I can ask myself, well, what do I need if I'm going to apply to Sandbox University? What kind of documentation, what kind of information do I need to know? Well, I can either click on the logo here on the elective opportunity, or from the Visiting Electives Guide, and I'll end up on the Sandbox University institution profile. And this is basically a page of information where the university will give me all kinds of details. For example, it'll be the contact information over here, any information that the university wants to make available to students. We can look at the different student types, and we can find out about fees, whether or not the registration window is open, and we can see required documents here at the bottom right. Now at the bottom, you'll find tabs for various types of information. These are variable by school, but the layout will always be similar. So we can hear about housing or code of conduct in this case. An FAQ is a common thing. Immunization and forms. Here you can see we borrowed McMaster's form. And just various tabs that can contain different types of information. So it's always a good idea to go through the institution profile to get those details. So now that I have picked out some electives that I want to apply for, and I've looked up and I see which documents are required for the application, I have to upload those documents to my profile. There's a document section here at the top, and it's very important to add documents to the portal before you apply. You must have your documents in the portal. You cannot upload them dynamically during the application process. So you'll notice that I have a few documents here uploaded already, simply because I've gone through the applications before. But if I wanted to upload something, I could just click on Add New, and the Upload Document interface will come up. I can name my document anything I like. Always make sure that you name it something relevant, because the name of your file might not match what the school is calling a particular document, so make sure it's something you can track down. And I can choose a file. Now in this case, I've already uploaded my police check, but I could pick it if I wanted to. There you can see my police check. And then the upload button goes red. So I could re-upload this file if I wanted to. In this case, I'll just go back to the list. Now the other thing you want to notice is that I have two different immunization record forms. That's because each university is going to have a different requirement for that form. So I can keep all my forms for the different universities I want to apply for at the ready in my documents list. So when I apply, I just have to choose the proper forms. So my profile is complete. My wish list has the electives I want to apply for, and I've uploaded my documents. It's time to apply. Now there are three ways that I can do this. I can click on Applications, and I can create application. Or I can go to the wish list, where you'll see the two electives that I added previously, and I can click on the Apply Now button over on the right. Or there's the blue button we saw on the student dashboard. They all lead back to this screen here. Now when I click on Select a Medical School, I can pick AFMC Sandbox University, because there are elective opportunities from that school in my wish list. This is entirely dependent on which schools you've added to your wish list. Now Sandbox is mentioned here. Before applying, please ensure you've uploaded all the required documents and complete your core rotations in my profile. We've done that already. Now we can pick the language that we want to apply in, and we can click the Apply button at the bottom. Now here we see the application form. Now the application form can have different content from one school to the next, but it will always have the same layout. The same tabs are always going to be present at the top. Now the first tab is key. It's the elective information. This is where we tell the school which elective opportunities we want to apply for. Now, you'll notice that there's a checkbox here that says elective one. We have to check at the very least one elective. So we're going to apply for one. I'm going to select 2 weeks. And then this button enables itself, where I can select my elective opportunity. Now you'll see that it's showing me two different elective opportunities, the two that I added from Sandbox U to my wish list. So I'm just going to pick the first one. I'm just going to leave the dates by default. If I were to try to pick a date that's not allowed by the university, I'd actually get an error message. So you can only ever apply for allowed dates. Now, within one elective, I can supply more than one choice. In this case, I can supply three, which means that I can tell them I want these 2 weeks, but it can be either of these electives. Now, you'll notice here that there are three choices. This means that I can give three different options for this elective. Now, if I click on the Please Select button, you'll see that it brings the one left over, the internal medicine opportunity. Now, I can leave the same dates, or I can choose completely different ones. This means that the school could award me one or the other. I won't get both, but it gives the university options as to what they can award me, so it gives them more options to place me. Now, you'll notice that the description of the elective opportunity shows up, as well as some of the key details. If there were multiple locations to choose from, I could select one from the drop-down at the top right. Now, I don't have a third elective in my wish list, so I can't add a third choice. Now, here I can specify my learning objectives, as well as any comments I might have. Now, you'll notice here that Sandbox 2 shows Elective 2. That means that if I enable that, I could apply for a second elective. It would have to be a different set of dates, because I'm not allowed to have two electives booked for the same date. That means that Sandbox 2 could potentially award me one elective, either one or two, or they could award me both, which is why it's important to not have overlapping dates. In this case, to keep it simple, I'm going to stay with elective one. Now, the document upload section shows us the same list of documents that we saw on the institution profile. It's very important to notice that there's a required column. Now, some of these say yes and some of these say no. If it says yes to the required column, that means that you must include this document with your application in order to submit it. If it says no, the document is not required to be able to successfully submit your application, but it's still a good idea to attach it either now or have it on your profile at the ready, because the university will most likely request it from you later. So in this case, I'm just going to attach the required documents, such as my birth certificate, my photo, my immunization record, and in this case, I want the one for Sandbox University. And last but not least, my police check. Now, if there were anything else that I wanted to attach to my application, I could do so with the Add Optional Document button here at the top right. But I'm happy with the documents that I've attached. Now, in the Academic tab, this copies information from your student profile. So really, it's just a matter of going over the information about your home school and confirming that that is correct. You also want to look at your core rotations and your clinical electives. Make sure that you're not missing anything. Now, if you notice that there's something missing from your core rotations or from your documents that you forgot to include beforehand, you don't have to cancel your application. You can save the application as a draft here at the top right. You'll get a confirmation message that your application has been saved as a draft. You can go back to the My Profile section or to the Document section, upload the information that's missing, and then you can resume from the Applications menu under In Draft. Right now, my application is fairly complete, so I'm going to keep going. The Personal tab has all the information from your Contact tab in the My Profile. So it'll have your name, your contact information, as well as your emergency contact. Now, this information is directly editable in this part of the form, which means that I could change my emergency contact for this application. A good example of that is if I'm going to have an elective in a different province than I normally would, I can list an emergency contact that's closer to that school. The other tab will have any additional questions that the school has chosen to include with the application. Now, you'll notice here that we've just added some test questions, some yes or no options, and a drop-down. But this could include anything, or it could include nothing at the university's discretion. The Payment tab is fairly self-explanatory. This is where you'll put in your credit card information to pay for the application. Now, you'll see that the Payment Information tab lists the basic and late fee, as well as the total. You'll be asked for your credit card type. You'll be asked to put in your credit card number and your name and expiry date. Now, once we have all this filled out, even if we save the application as a draft, this information will not be included in the application. If you save as a draft after putting in your payment information and come back, the payment information section will be blank. This is a security feature because the AFMC does not want to hang on to your payment information. We only ever want you to put this in to submit the application so that we can transfer this information directly to our payment processor. We don't keep your credit card details at any time. Now the last tab in the application is the summary tab. Now here you can see your personal information and contact, homeschool, the elective information for what you've requested, your documents, your core rotations and clinical electives, and your payment information. This gives you a chance to review everything and make sure that there are no oversights. One of the last steps is to check the box that says, I have read and agree to abide by the above statement. And here you have three options. You can click the previous button, which will take you to the last tab where you can review some information. You can click on the submit button, which will do just that, submit the application to the university. Or you can click on submit and update my profile. And what that does is it will not only submit your application, but if you changed any information in the personal section, it will copy it back to your application, or pardon me, to your student profile. And this is relevant in the event that you change your contact information because you've moved, or you have a new emergency contact, and you want that information to be represented in your profile so that you don't have to change it next time. That is when you would make use of the Submit and Update My Profile button. Today, I'm just going to submit. Now I've got a confirmation here that the application has been submitted. There's also an email headed to my inbox right now that'll tell me the same thing. And from here on in, when I go to the student dashboard, I'll see that there was an application submitted to AFMC Sandbox University. There's the application number and the submission date. Now I know that that application is under review, so now all I have to do is wait for the school to review it. That concludes today's tutorial video about how to submit an application through the AFMC Student Portal. Thank you, and until next time.